The Ribhu Gita, Chapter 50, Skandha says, following the hymn recited by Vishnu, the Brahmana Sudarshana bathed in the Manikarnika tank, smeared the sacred ashes and decked himself with the Rudraksha garland. He chanted the Satarudriyam and took refuge in the Panchakshara mantra. He gathered the sacred bilva foliage and blemishless lotuses, and along with sandal paste, unbroken rice grain, immense incense smoke, lamps and food offerings, worshipped the Sivalingam as per the instructions of Vishnu within the interior of his abode. Performing circumambulations, he also with exceeding joy worshipped within the house the Lord with myriad names such as Vishveshwara, Avimuktesha, Viresha, Trilochana, Krittivasa, Vridhakala, Kedara, Sulatankaka, Ratnesha, Bharabhutesha, Chandresha, Siddhakeshwara, Ghantakeshwara, Naradesha, Yameshwara, Pulastishwara, Pulaheshwara, Vikarnesha, Faleshwara, Kadrudresha, Akhandesha, Ketumali, Gabhastika, Yamunisha, Varnakesha, Bhadresha, Jeshtha Sankara, Nandikesha, Ramesha, Karamardeshwara, Avardesha, Matangesha, Vasukisha, Dhrutishwara, Suryesha, Aryamisha, Tunisha, Galavishwara, Kanvisha, Katyayanesha, Chandra Chudeshwara, Udavarteshwara, Tranya Jyotishwara, Kankanesha, Tankanesha, Skandesha, Tarakeshwara, Jambukesha, Jnanesha, Nandisha, and Ganapeshwara. Day by day, he extensively worshipped Dhundi Ganesha and other chiefs of hosts, Bhairava, Annapurna, the bestower of food, and verily the sole mother of the universe, and Dandapani, the protector of the sacred center. The sage performed ritualistic baths in various sacred waters such as Manikarnika, Gnanoda, Siddhakupa, Vridhakupa, Pisachaka, Runamochana, Garga, Panchananda, Kirana, Dhuta Papa, Panchaganga, and in the sin effacing lofty waves of the enchanting Ganga. Repairing to the hall called Mukti Mantapa, he chanted the Satarudriyam Ashtotara, 108 names, and Sahasra, 1000 names, and the Panchakshara. Every fortnight he performed circumambulation to the Panchakrosa city of Kashi. As he lived thus in the outer precincts of his house, time turned pleasant for him. Seeing Sudarshana there as one established in penance and a worshipper of Shiva, Vishnu addressed the Brahmana and spoke again to the noble sage with a pleasing countenance. Vishnu said, O Sudarshana, best among sages and adorer of Shiva, now you have indeed become fit for knowledge by the grace of Vishwanatha, Lord of Universe. You have undertaken penance and performed sacred rites. You have practiced the Vedas and have chosen to stay in Kashi. One who has rendered great penance in a sacred center, by him alone the immaculate Kashi is attained as bestower of liberation. O sage, you are fortunate. There is no limit to the wealth of your achievements. Listen, I shall further reveal that which is the ultimate good to you. By the grace of Vishveshwara, you shall finally attain liberation. I shall initiate you into the sacred hymn of the 1000 names of Rudraksha. Along with this, you must worship Vishveshwara with attractive bilva leaves. This service to Shiva you must undertake for a year, forsaking food. At the end of the year, you shall attain liberation. There is no doubt of this. At the time of the dissolution of your body, the Lord Vishveshwara himself will grant you the supreme Panchakshara mantra by which you will be liberated. This great mantra is given to the noblest of the followers of Shiva. Skandha said, hearing these utterances of Vishnu, Sudarshana paid obeisance to Hari and spoke thus, Lord, vanquisher of demons, Vishnu, Jishnu, I salute you. Pray impart to me at once the choicest and the divine hymn of thousand names of Vishvesa, by the chanting of which, along with the worship with Bilva foliage, the Lord God grants the kingdom of liberation at the time of death. Hari heard this supplication of the Brahmana and imparted to him the thousand names of the Lord, such as Hiranyasya. Chanting these names, the Brahmana with great dedication worshipped Vishveshwara along with tender and pink Bilva foliage and hymned thus with intense delight. Sudarshana said, he whose neck is entwined by venomous snakes, whose throat is shining sparkle of the poison arisen from the ocean, the flame of whose blaze third eye illuminates the quarters, whose eye is the sun, who has the moon on the crown, who is wearing the emaciated moon, who has a resplendent half body, may he readily protect me. Protect me, O Shambhu, who destroyed the sacrifice of the enemy Daksha, who punished the demon Andhaka, who reclined on the mountain tops, the sinful wigs of which were cut off by Indra. O wielder of the Pinaka bow, your throat is aglow with the garland of Karavira flowers in full blossom. You are wearing the luminous moon like a gorgeous flower bud in your elegant crown. One who worships the linga of the master robbed of hearts, who is in the company of Mother Ambika with petals of ruddy hue like the brother of the sun Aruna, with devotion becomes liberated oneself and shines bright amongst the millions of his ancestors. The worshipper of the eminent linga of Sangha, the bull mounted at dusk and at dawn, becomes an expert in rendering his sins not and remains ever unattached. Let us praise the linga of Shankara, who has burnt Manmatha, rendering him bodiless, with an effulgent spark emanated from his fiery third eye, who wears the hide of a mammoth elephant, and who removes the hardships of the celestials with a glance of grace. Those who ever with their eyes feast upon the form of the Lord, sporting in the pure white Kailasha mountain and in the company of Uma, is ever seated upon the bull mount, are the blessed ones who have transcended birth and destruction, with their tongues ever glorifying the names of Shambhu. They are pure by themselves. Let us adore the one who wears the moon in the crown, who wears the hide of lion's foe, the elephant, who is effulgent like the moon, who sports the baby deer in the hands, and who is shining like a lion. Skandha said, as Sudarshana had been thus engaged in extolling Vishveshwara without remiss, Vishnu spoke to him so as to intensify his devotion to Shambhu. Vishnu said, O Brahmana, stay here until death with diet under check and engage yourself chanting the thousand names and the Satarudriyam. Staying in the outer precincts of the house, ever worship Maheshwara, who out of abundant grace will grant liberation in the end. Saluting Vishveshwara, Vishnu continued thus looking at Sudarshana. Blessed are you, all the sins of your heart are rendered not. You are the choicest among men, rooted in the hoary tradition that you are resort to the propitiation of the universally acclaimed Lord at dawn, along with the control of body and mind, by offering to his linga bilva leaves or lotus petals and a little water repeatedly. You shall attain the liberation, bestowing feet of Ishvara, the consort of Shiva, who is there comparable to you in according loving worship of the Lord of the Mount of Kailasha. Among the best of the liberated ones, with their locks tied atop and with the seeds of devotion sprouted fully, who can equal you? Gods, demons, celestials, or the best among sages are only a burden to the world. None is a match to you in offering garlands of Karavira flowers. One who worships the Linga of the consort of Girija with a controlled mind, whether in a forest or in a kingdom, or such a votary of Hara, is possible to consider the three worlds a blade of grass. For him, with such rooted conviction, no wealth of the world can be a match. Those who accord charities, undertake yoga, follow the systems of caste and orders of life, assimilate the esoteric meanings of the Vedic utterances, cannot come even close to be compared with the one whose heart cave brims with the bliss of transcendence by the adoration of the Sangha Linga within. Those who have touched the other shore of the ocean called the bliss of the Lord, the consort of the daughter of the Himalaya mountain, whose hearts have renounced attachment, who are supremely dispassionate, who relish the smearing of sacred ashes, who are not smitten by the sharp shafts of lust, who are brimming with the essence of self-vigilance by the loving adoration of Sarva Shiva, cross the great ocean of sinful transmigration. One whose mind is in love with the lotus feet of the Lord Hara, that of yore saved the boy Markandeya from the terror of death. What fruits can there be to attain? Yet those who pay obeisance to the vanquisher of death attain release from the stages of birth, senility, and disease, and are charged with spirit. This is a matter beyond the question of disease and failure. Once a sinful huntsman of dark complexion with his bow and arrow chased after a bear. In the meantime, a tiger came after him. Frightened, he climbed a tree which happened to be the sacred bilwa. To evade sleep, he started plucking the leaves and threw them down, which happened to fall on the Shivalinga situated at the base of the tree. By this unintentional act of merit, he was cleansed of sins and transformed into the celebrated host of Shiva. His feet were worshipped by the gods of death, Yama, the son of the sun. Having attained the form of the Lord with a matted crown, embellished with the flowing Ganga and the crescent moon, a blazing fire in the forehead, a ruddy baby deer at the tip of the hand, and a giant trident, he arose with exceeding grandeur. O king among Brahmins, the fruits of worshipping Shivalinga with sacred bilwa leaves is in various months of the year are as follows. In the month of Chaitra, the Brahmana will be released from extraordinary sins by worshipping with bilvas. In the month of Vaisakha, one is set free from the ramification of sorrow. In the month of Jyeshta, one becomes the distinguished. In Ashada, one will be blessed with a son. Shravana destroys tendium. Protection is granted in Bhadrapada. Ashwini bestows rain over horses, senses. Fame is achieved in Kartika. The path to liberation is found in Margasira. Merit in Pushya. Effacement of shortcomings in Magha and eradication of unworthiness in the month of Falguna are accomplished. By worshipping the Linga of the moon-decked Lord with fresh blades of Durva grass, sprouts of horrific worldly existence. By worshipping the Linga of the moon-decked Lord with fresh blades of Durva grass, sprouts of horrific worldly existence are destroyed at once, and seeds of liberation will sprout in abundance, and one is blessed right here. By bathing the Vishveshwara Linga with cow's milk, sugarcane juice, honey, sugar water, ghee, tender coconut water, cardamom essence, juice extracts from jackfruit and mango, and by smearing sandalwood paste, one is rid of sins. One who sees the Linga of Uma's consort is never smitten by the serpent of worldly existence and is liberated from association with the love god Manmatha, who is devoid of form. By rendering all-round worship of Shankara Linga, a cripple turns whole and ever reveals in the gracious side glance of Sangha. arranging dance services to the Lord of Bhagavati Girija during new moon, performed by the choicest dancing girls to the melodious accomplishments of flute, drums, cymbals, conches and various other instruments reverberating the quarters is a means of liberation. By decorating the Sivalinga with various finery and ornaments and by offering shade with a parasol to the crown of the Linga, the devotee of Shiva, his sins having been destroyed, gets rid of worldly existence through the devotional worship of Shambhu. The supreme Shivalinga associated with dazzling chamara fans embellished with blemishless golden handles, with gem-studded tops, lustrous like the full moon, clothed in crisp attire and resplendent with free fluttering flags, with the crown showing petals of ruddy shades and kissing the starry sky, covered with sacred bilwa leaves, granting a feast of joy to the world at large and destroying great accumulation of sins. Such a sight of it is pleasing to Shambhu. O Shambhu, food, should it be a hindrance in remembering you, feels like the excreta of swine. Fresh rain water tastes like dog's urine. Sleep turns into fettering chains. Bliss becomes sorrow and breathing feels like a sword. When the wish-fulfilling kalpa tree is at hand, will anyone hanker after the cotton plant which reduces one's merits? Will a hungry person resort to the babula tree which is good only to disperse wind? Similarly, if a servant of Shankara chances to serve Brahma, Hari, Indra, Chandra or Agni, it is because he is deceived by fate and also due to the ill effects of the dark force of Kali. Rare indeed in this world is the one who with supreme devotion extols your feet, which were worshipped by Adisesha with hymns arising from the cosmic golden egg. Let us ever praise the Lord with blemishless locks decked with the moon, who is the performer of Tandava dance and for whom the universe has manifested with great force and splendor. Protect me who am without refuge, O Shambho, holding the bow Ajagava and Vishnu for the arrow. Who is the eraser of sins and who is the destroyer of death? Pray render now my mind the pond for the lotus of your eminent feet that remove fear. Vishnu in this manner instructed the best among the Brahmins the methods of worshipping the venerable Vishveshwara, the chief of Pramatha hosts in Kashi. In the end, the Brahmana became merged along with his whole body in the lotus feet of the Lord of Pramatha hosts and attained liberation amidst the sages. Sutta says, hearing thus the sixth canto from the six-faced Shanmukha, Jaijishavya, the best among sages, became blissful within and with salutations said the following. Jaijishavya said, O son of the one who killed Manmatha, O resort of bliss, pray narrate to me the wondrous accounts of the Lord and his thousand names too. O repository of grace, for me there is no other guru but you who vanquished the demons Sura and Taraka. Reveal to me the glories of the sacred centers and others too. Hearing these supplicatory words of the sage, Skanda addressed him thus. Skandha said, you shall now listen to the grand account of the upcoming seventh canto, which will be like a moonrise upon the ocean of your heart. The thousand names are much dear to the Lord Shambho. You shall listen with earnestness to the glory of Kashi, the forest of joy. This seventh canto, recounted by the moon-decked Lord, is the essence of the Vedanta and is called Ugra. The sixth canto was given to the noble Shanmukha and again to Brahma. The son of the latter heard the word eschewing knowledge and became a knower of Brahman. It is said that one who hears this is rid of even great sins amassed over hundreds of years. This canto removes sin and worldly suffering. It is grand and the best locale of Shiva. By meditating upon it and by devotion to the feet of Shambhu, wisdom and the realization of the self are attained. Sutta said, even a single line from a chapter, if meditated upon with one's heart and mind, will ensure release from worldly bondage. To the one who is tired of traditional learning and who is quiescent, this knowledge may be imparted without hesitation. Having heard thus the narration from Sutta, the assembly of great sages was overwhelmed with intense jubilation, and as they became resplendent like the sun, extolled him, with their minds fulfilled by the blessings they received in the form of Vedic utterances. They cried victories to Sita, and with overjoyed hearts they proceeded to have the sacred site of Vishveshwara. Thus concludes chapter 50 entitled The Attainment of Liberation by Sudarshana and the Description of the Merits of Hearing the Canto in the sixth Amsha called Shankara of Sri Shiva Rahasyam. Thus concludes in full the sixth Amsha called Shankara. Om Namah Shivaya.